Hello everyone, this is Revanth from Digi Integrity. Welcome to Tech News episode 258. The customers of India's largest bank, State Bank of India, will not be able to use the internet banking service tomorrow for a certain period. The users of SBI internet banking services will not be able to use various features like internet banking, YONO, YONO Lite and UPI for a total duration of 300 minutes on Saturday and Sunday due to scheduled maintenance activities. Google has announced to bring Android application to Windows. Google has said Google Play Games application will arrive on Windows next year. Windows began offering Android application through Amazon App Store with Windows 11. Samsung is working in the background on a rollable smartwatch according to a newly released patent. It's a Galaxy Watch with two display parts which can be pulled out as desired. The smartwatch also houses a camera for taking photo and video recordings. According to the leaked images of the Oppo Find N, some of the key specifications of this smartphone has been leaked online. It will be coming up with an 8GB RAM and a 256GB storage, and the price will be around 12,999 Chinese yuan. And if we talk about the second variant, 12GB RAM and a 512GB storage, it will be costing us around 13,999 Chinese yuan. The Oppo Find N will be fueled by the Snapdragon 888 processor. It won't include the latest Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor. When it comes to the cameras, this device is set to include a 50 megapixel main camera, that is Sony's IMX766 sensor, along with the 16 and 13 megapixel secondary cameras. Those two cameras are likely to be a telephoto and ultra wide angle units, and if we talk about the display, the main display will offer a 120Hz refresh rate and that will also be an LTPO panel. The secondary display on the other end will cap out a 60Hz when the refresh rate is concerned. The Oppo Find N will become official on December 15 during Oppo Inno Day 2021. Realme GT 2 Pro will get a 1TB storage option. The image also confirms Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 processor, 12GB of RAM and Realme UI 3.0 based on Android 12. Realme GT 2 Pro launch date is yet to be revealed by the company. Moto G51 5G launched in India at a launch price of around 14,999. The Moto G51 5G is powered by a Snapdragon 480 Plus processor, 5000mAh battery, a 50 megapixel triple camera setup, and runs on Android 11. The Moto G51 5G will be available in a sole 4GB RAM and a 64GB variant via Flipkart. Noyce has announced a new budget smartwatch in India today with the launch of the Noyce Fit Evolve 2. As the name suggests, the Noyce Fit Evolve 2 is a successor to the Noyce Fit Evolve, and the second generation smartwatch comes with an AMOLED display. It also sports multiple sport modes, fast charging and a bunch of health related features. The Noyce Fit Evolve 2 is priced at ₹3,999, which is said to be an introductory offer. Flipkart listing suggests that Noyce Fit Evolve 2 will be priced at ₹7,999 later on. The popular audio and smart wearable maker has announced a new affordable True Wireless earbuds in India. The newly launched Noyce Buds Prima True Wireless comes with the features like long-lasting battery life, quad microphone, quick charge and a low latency mode and more. The Noyce Buds Prima are priced at ₹1,799 and they are available in black, white and gold color options. The True Wireless will be available on Flipkart starting from December 14th at 12 noon. OnePlus 9RT and the OnePlus Buds Z2 support pages have been spotted on the Indian website. The OnePlus 9RT originally launched in China back in October. The key specifications include a 6.62-inch display, Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 processor, 65W fast charging support and runs on Android 12 OS. According to the leaked images of the upcoming Xiaomi 12 series lineup, the leaked images include three devices. The lineup includes Xiaomi 12, Xiaomi 12 Pro and the last one is Xiaomi 12 Ultra. Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra 5G has appeared on Geekbench 4 and 5 benchmarking application. The listing pretty much confirms the Snapdragon 8 Gen 1 chipset alongside the Android 12 OS. The Samsung Galaxy S22 Ultra is slated for an early 2022 launch with Feb 8th as a rumored launch date. Vivo unveiled its latest Origin OS Ocean update. IQ has confirmed that upcoming Neo 5S is set to debut on December 20th. This phone will debut with the brand new Android 12 based interface. The most affordable IQ Neo 5 software edition is also expected to debut with the Snapdragon 778G chipset. And the IQ Neo 5S will debut with the Qualcomm Snapdragon 888 processor along with the 8GB of RAM and a 128GB of storage based on the latest leak. The new MG Motor electric vehicle may cost up to ₹15 lakh. MG Motor currently offers ZS electric vehicle as its only fully electric offering in India. The company says that their next cheaper electric vehicle will be based on a global platform but will be customized for the Indian markets. The Honor X30 will go on official in China on December 16th, according to the leaked images on Weibo that reveals the X30's design with a circular camera array on the rear will exactly looks like an Honor Magic 3 and earlier. The Honor X30 is expected to have a Snapdragon 695 chipset and with an LCD with a 120Hz refresh rate. LG appears to be working on a new foldable panel for an in-car infotainment system. The South Korean giant has filed a patent at the World Intellectual Property Organization. The company would be using similar technology as it did for LG smart TVs and rollable phones. Krafton has disabled the recently added virus infection mode in Battlegrounds Mobile India. Krafton has not specified which issues led to virus infection mode being disabled in BGMI. The developer is working on fixing the issue and the virus infection mode should be back soon. PUBG Dev has announced that PUBG Battlegrounds is going free to play in 2022. All players who currently own PUBG Battlegrounds before it goes free to play will get some exclusive rewards. The developer is launching Battlegrounds Plus upgrade that offers a premium experience in PUBG Battlegrounds. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.